In this video, we are going to see some of the novelties added to the addon. The current version up to this video is 10241. First, we will see the new features added to the tools panel. These new options are designed to accelerate work to give hierarchies to branches and make it more comfortable. Here we have the branch parent indicator. With this option checked, it shows us the parent of the branch we are working on. Here you can see how the parent object of the branch is shown, and this way we know that the hierarchy of this branch goes in this direction. When rotating these objects, we see how the rest are children moving following the parent, which is the previous object. So with the branch parent indicator option, when selecting each branch is here on the fingers, we see which is the parent of the active branch. Seeing the parent, this is the direction of the children, and we see how it rotates respecting that hierarchy. If we change the direction of the branch, we have the parent on the other side, and now they rotate with the hierarchy the opposite of how they were before. As you know, we can always change the direction of the branches whenever we want with the P shortcut. The keyboard shortcut to show or hide the branch parent indicator is Shift plus V. We also have the option to see the branch parent indicators for all selected objects by pressing the shortcut, and if we press it again, it will show the indicator only for the branch of the active object or of all selected ones alternatively. Or when we have only the active one shown, pressing the shortcut again hides it. So if we create hierarchies for the branches and then join some with others, we will be able to pose the character or easily explore new possibilities of design for it. Until now, we had to use the keyboard shortcut P to tell the branch that it had to have hierarchy between the objects of that branch, in one direction or the other. Now with the automatic hierarchy in branch option, when we create a new branch with this option active, the branch will be created already with the hierarchy in the order in which we generate the new objects, extruding the branch with the keyboard shortcut E. If we have the automatic hierarchy in branch activated, you can see that the branch already has the hierarchy in the order in which it has been created. Here we have to, now we can try how it articulates, and we can see the parent for this branch. If we deactivate it, the branch we create will not have hierarchy between the objects that make it up, so they rotate around themselves. If we create it without hierarchy, we can use as always the keyboard shortcut P to give it hierarchy in one direction or the other. Again, if we now create one starting from a new object, activating the automatic hierarchy in branch, now this new branch will have hierarchy according to how it has been created. So by combining these simple tools, we have the possibility of giving hierarchies to the character as quickly with the P shortcut for one direction or another, and this is how the trunk behaves, as you can see here. Then we will join some branches with others to create hierarchies for the entire character and give it the ability to be posed or easily explore new possibilities of design. To help us join branches quickly, we have the following smart parent option. So, with the smart parent option, when we want to make a branch a child of another branch, by selecting any object of the child branch, having smart parent activated, the addon will look for the parent of that branch, and that object will be the one that is a child of the active object. This makes it so you don't have to go selecting the specific object that is going to be the child, and it is faster. Here we already have this arm being a child of the active object in the trunk. Before we had to go to the object that would be the child of the branch, this one here. Sometimes it was difficult to be selected because it was hidden, and then when we have the active object apparent with the keyboard shortcut. Now we can select any and just worry about which object should be the parent and leave it as active. The selected branches will look for their parent object to parent it to the active one. Let's see how to do it with the legs. We select any object from the legs and activate the object that will be the parent in the torso, and that's it. Let's check. Done, the two legs branches are daughters of the trunk. Let's see it one more time with the fingers of the hand. Before we selected the parent objects of the fingers branches and activate the parent. Now we select any object and make active the one that will be the parent of all those branches. Let's check. Now we can pose the character and see how it feels moving it. Now we're going to see a bit how having hierarchies in the branches, in addition to helping to easily pose characters without any rigging knowledge, change proportions, and how useful this is to make modifications to the character and quickly test different results. We can manage the branches and modify their objects while maintaining the hierarchies and thus adjusting different parts change their appearance. We can adjust proportions by adjusting using the hierarchy in the branches, or we could temporarily remove it with the keyboard shortcut, or if we want to edit the individual objects, we can do it in edit mode or sculpt mode. When we finish, we can use the hierarchy given to the character to try posing it. You know that all the keyboard shortcuts are configurable in the addon preferences. If you like the channel, if you want the addon to continue improving, support us by subscribing, liking, help us spread the word about the addon. Thank you very much.